Hello friends, in this video lecture we are going to study about how to interface temperature, humidity and the moisture sensor with PIC microcontroller. So first of all we will go for the interfacing diagram in the PROTISET module. I have shared already the procedure related with PROTISET module. So directly we will go for the interfacing diagram. In the interfacing diagram you can see diagram is already made in the PROTISET professional model. The controller which I have selected is PIC18F4550. I am going to interface three temperature sensor. First of all LM35, then followed by the humidity sensor, and the third one is moisture sensor. So LM35 sensor gives me the output in terms of voltage. Humidity sensor, here I can go for the HS230 sensor, moisture sensor, respective moisture sensor. I have connected the output of all these three sensors to the RA0, RA1 and RA2 channel, that is the analog channels of internal ADC of the PIC microcontroller. Now I have interfaced the LCD to the port D, data lines to the port D, and the control line RS, RW and enable to the RE0, RE1 and RE2 pin. PIC microcontroller's first pin, that is MCLR master clear reset pin, should be connected to the VCC. One more, that is I have connected one DC motor with DC voltage of 12 volt, and with another end, that is the negative end, is connected to the collector of this opto isolator. The opto isolator acts as a switch. RC0, if I am sending one value to the RC0, then opto isolators, this diode will conduct, this diode, that is light emitting diode, will emit the light at the base of this transistor, and this transistor will be conducted and the current will flow through the motor towards the ground and the motor will be conducted. So what we are going to do, first of all we have to display the LM35's temperature, that is real time temperature. 39 degrees Celsius should be displayed over here. Humidity sensor, it will give me the relative humidity of the environment, and the moisture sensor, it will give me the content of water present or the moisture present from the soil. So here you can see I have used variable pot. So I will just show you one procedure related how to select these components. So first of all you have to go into the components mode. Suppose I want to go for the LM35 sensor, so go into the components mode, then click on P, and here just type your keyword as LM35. So you can go for the LM35 sensor, which sensor you want. I would go for this sensor, and just you have to click on OK. So that device will get added in your device list over here like this. This is nothing but a pot edge. You can search for this keywords from this procedure, that is component mode P and pot edge. Similarly you will require the power sources as well as this DC source as well as the ground. So how to select this power sources? You have to go into the terminals mode, just select power, and that power will, you have to drag down those power on the schematic. So just I will remove that power source. So in order to remove, go into the selection mode, click on that and just press delete button. And in order to take the ground, you can take that ground from the same, that is terminals mode and ground. So why I have taken here variable resistors? Because the output of the humidity sensor is nothing but a variable voltage. Similarly output of the moisture sensor is also variable voltage. I am going to read those voltages and I am going to display those value onto the LCD. So what I am going to do, if the moisture content is less from the soil, I have to turn on this DC motor, and DC motor is nothing but your pump, electric pump. This system, overall system, is comes under the data acquisition system, and you can call this as a smart irrigation system. In case of smart irrigation system, it is taking care of the temperature, the humidity of the environment, as well as the content of water present in the soil. So I will just simulate this. So before simulation, you have to go into the MPLAB IDE software. I have uploaded or already shared the video related with procedure of MPLAB IDE. So you have to write your code, embedded C code, into the source file. I have written that code for the explanation. I will upload one more video related with the explanation of the logic of this. The code is very simple, and for more details you can visit the www.wikinote.org in that microcontroller subject. So just I have to add this file as a source file, and I have to build this file. As this file will be built, zero errors, that means the file will be build succeeded message will appear, and as soon as it comes you have to go onto the PIC microcontroller, double click, you have to give the appropriate path and you have to select that hex file. So just click on OK and start the simulation. So you can see the message such as irrigation system is displayed, temperature, current temperature is 39, from LM35 is also 39 degrees Celsius, moisture content is 40, humidity sensor provides me the relative humidity, that is 108%, and moisture sensor providing me the relative moisture, that is 47.9%, and as this value is more than the threshold, so that's why the motor is off. So now if I am increasing the temperature, see the effect. Whatever will be the real time temperature, that will be displayed over here. Current temperature is 43 degrees Celsius. It will also show the 43 degrees Celsius, but in the next process. So just I will wait. Okay, almost it's showing 42.0 degrees Celsius. Okay, I have to look after this, but okay, no problem. Real time temperature will be displayed over here. Related with humidity sensor, I can go for the checking of the humidity. I can decrease that humidity. Previously it was 108%, you can see now it has been decreased to 090%, that is 90%. Moisture content, now right now it's showing something 47.9%. Now I will decrease that humidity level, moisture level. So once it will be below that threshold value, that is under 30%, then your motor should be turned on, motor on. So that means see here, one is provided over here and motor will rotate in clockwise direction. Motor is nothing but your pump. You can see the rotation of the motor is visible now. Hope that you like my video. Please do share this video with others, like my videos and subscribe to my channel. Also visit www.wikinote.org for more details. Happy WikiNoting!